Other news here at 9, a 16-year-old East High School student who was shot Monday outside the school is fighting for his life in the ICU tonight. Fox 31's Nicole Fierro speaking to friends and loved ones, identifying the teen as they battle the question, why him? Nicole, what can you tell us?
Yeah, a question they are desperately searching for answers for. Luis Garcia, the 16-year-old, here in critical condition tonight with his family, won't leave his side. And they tell us something really sad. They say that he had left school just a few minutes early to try to go home and decorate the house to celebrate one of his loved one's birthdays. When he was driving, just leaving the school, he was shot.
Monday afternoon, close to the end of the day at East High School.
We heard the gunshots, we went on lockdown, and an hour or two later, I saw a picture of the car. It looked like his car.
Sadra, an East High School student, talking to us about her close friend.
He was shot in the head.
Luis Garcia, the 16-year-old shot right by the school.
His brother, Santos, was supposed to be giving you this interview, but he took a turn for the worse.
Sadra just got a message updating on Garcia's condition in the ICU. Loved ones refused to leave his bedside at Denver Health.
He is now being put on the medication that they called the last resort, and they told us to prepare for anything.
An unthinkable task, knowing just who Garcia is.
I find him to be one of the most hardworking, compassionate, kind, driven people that I've ever met.
Driven on the soccer team, compassionate enough to coach Sadra's little brother on the field, making it so hard for her to understand how this could happen.
It's heartbreaking, and I just keep on trying to understand. I just don't understand why something like this could happen to anyone, let alone Luis, who's just an amazing person.
Denver police tells us investigators are also trying to figure out why right now. They did arrest two teens, not specifically for this shooting at this point, but for investigation of having an illegal gun, auto theft, and eluding police. As for Garcia here in the hospital, there's been a GoFundMe made to help support him and his family during this time. That's on this story on our website. Reporting live in Denver, Nicole Fierro, Fox 31.
We're definitely thinking about the Garcia family tonight. Nicole, thank you.